Okay, Bianca, look, is this really so terrible?
It's embarrassing, Uncle Jack.
I embarrass you.
No, you don't embarrass me. It's just this whole situation. I do not need you here shopping for school with me. I mean, I'm not 10 years old.
So it's my chaperoning techniques. They're too hands-on, right?
Two prison guards.
Ouch. Well, how many prisoners get to go shopping with their Uncle Jack's platinum, huh?
You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I'll tell you what else I know. I know your mother grounded you because you skipped school and you lied. And as far as I'm concerned, that's decent grounds for grounding.
Whatever.
So are you gonna take it out on me all day here, or what?
No.
Good.
I'm sorry, Uncle Jack. It's just...
Yeah, I know. I also know that I enjoy spending time with you, and I don't care what the reason, okay?
Me too.
Good.
At least Mom realized that I'd probably go into orbit if she came down here with me and started trying to buy me dresses for school or something really evil like that.
Dresses? Evil? I'll remember that. So, no dresses. Where do we start?
Somewhere you can't go.
Why is that?
I need something personal, okay, Uncle Jack? Oh my God. Just trust me on this one. I'll be right back.
Okay, wait, but you know, I told your mother that I would, you know.
Whoa. Uncle Jack, you're saying you don't trust me?
No, I'm not saying that. I do trust you. I was just told.
I'm not gonna go running off in the mall like a loser in some after school special or something. Uncle Jack, I'll be right back.
Okay. Oh, hey. Hi, guys. How are you? Listen, have you seen Bianca anyplace around here?
No. I haven't seen her.
No, neither have I. Is everything all right?
Well, yeah, sure, it's fine. It's just this parenting thing's a little more than I thought it was gonna be. I'm standing in for Erica.
And you let Bianca get more than 10 feet away from you?
Yes.
You are in trouble! You want us to help you look for her?
No. I don't think that'd be a very good idea. I think she'd have a conniption fit if I set a church party made up of grown-ups out to find her. So I'm gonna just remain calm and just, you know, she's not here in 30 seconds. Then I'll call in the reinforcements. How you guys doing? Okay.
Well, we're good.
Good.
Yeah, we're fine. Thanks. All right. Good luck.
Thank you very much. I know you're on my side. So, you ladies do this every year to raise money for the soccer team. Okay, that's great.
Yeah. Hi, I'm ready.
Oh, hey, there you are. Listen, I'm glad you're here. I was just about to ask these young ladies to help me find you.
I said I'd be right back. Can we go?
Yeah, but first I'd like you to meet some of your new classmates. I mean, obviously they go to Pine Valley High School.
Hi. What's your name?
This is Bianca Montgomery. She's my niece, just here from Seattle. And this is Shannon and Mindy. And this is Heather. How do I do?
I'm just fine, sir.
Sir, well, you could have gone all day without saying that.
It was really nice to meet you guys, Uncle Jack.
Sure. But these young ladies have been so helpful. I'd just like to, I tell you what, let me get a dozen of those chocolate bars. How's that?
You look familiar.
Can't be because of the shoes. I guess grunge lives on in the Pacific Northwest.
Actually, I got these here, and I was never a big fan of grunge. So, later.
So, this is great, huh? Now when you go to school, you'll see some friendly faces.
Wait a minute. I've got it. I saw your picture in the paper. You're Erica Kane's daughter.
What?
She said her name was like Montgomery or something.
Yeah, that's my dad. It was my dad. My parents divorced.
That is awesome. Your mother is like so famous.
She's huge. I love her makeup. My mom begged my stepfather for enchantment perfume last Christmas. I steal it all the time. See?
Great.
Well, that's something to tell your mom about, huh?
I would die to meet her.
Well, listen, one day you can come home after school with Bianca, maybe for a sleepover or some such thing. You'll all get to meet her.
Definitely. You are, like, so in. It's not funny.
You won't ever have to worry about anything now that you're with us.
Thanks.
Just find us during lunch, and we'll introduce you to who you have to know.
Well, this is great, huh?
And we'll point out who you shouldn't go near. Do you get free enchantment lipstick and stuff? Because whatever you don't want, we'll take. I love Jungle Fever best.
Oh, me too. See you tomorrow, Bianca.
Thanks for the contribution, Mr. Montgomery.
Oh, you bet, girls, anytime. We'll see you at the car wash. That was kind of nice, huh? Now, at least when you go to school, being the new kid won't be quite so hard or quite so scary. What?
Uncle Jack, this is completely awful.
What is?
I cannot believe that I ever agreed to go to high school here. This is like my worst nightmare. It's worse than a nightmare.
Wait. Oh, hi. Did you get what you needed?
Yeah, I'm all set. Thanks.
Good. Listen, Bianca, I was thinking, did I do the right thing introducing you to those girls? Anything?
You're just trying to help, Uncle Jack.
Oh, yeah, I was definitely trying to help, but did I?
Why do you ask?
Well, I was thinking about what you said about agreeing with your mother's idea for you to go to Pine Valley High School, how that was going to be a nightmare.
Uncle Jack, those girls.
What about those girls? Those girls seem fine. They weren't?
There were some girls like that in my old school in Seattle. The only good thing about that place was that it was about 3,000 miles from here.
Yeah, and 3,000 miles away from your mother.
Everybody has their own opinion of her, you know? It's like her books and her husbands, and it's really hard to get past.
Yes, believe me, I know. But we're both very proud of her, aren't we?
It's just that everybody just gets so hung up on my being Erica Kane's daughter. Nobody wants to know me for who I am. Does that make any sense?
Come on, I don't believe that for a second.
Uncle Jack, they're cheerleaders.
Yeah, the uniform gave them away. Are cheerleaders genetically incapable of being decent human beings?
I could see what they were doing. They were totally dissing me until they found out that Erica Kane was my mother. That's the only thing that makes me fit in, and it's not the way I want to fit in, you know? I mean, it's never about who I am or getting to know me. It's about getting closer to my mother, the celebrity. It's never about who I am.
Well, I, for one, would love to know who you really are. If you'd let me. Oh, that was dumb. It was dumb again, wasn't it?
No, you dumb. Just...
Oh.
Older, is that better?
Oh, yes, that's a lot better. Thank you very much. Now, you listen to me. I love you just the way you are. And by, if I ever... What? What, honey? What did I say?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, Bianca, tell me, what is it? I miss your father as much as you do.
I know.
I know sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night. Something I just have to tell him right then.
Yeah.
But I even go to the phone and I start dialing. And it takes me a minute to realize that... that he's really gone, you know? And then I can never call him again. When I realize that Uncle Jack my legs just go weak.
Willis, I know I can't take your dad's place. But if you ever want to talk about something, and I mean anything, I would be honored if you would give me a call like you used to call your dad. And I promise, I'll listen to every word you say. Let's go, Tom.